I actually came to Penn State in 1996, and I had just finished up my PhD work. Lisa was serving as an assistant dean at East Carolina University, and it was a big decision for us whether I was going to try to get a tenure track job. So I did a nationwide search. This position came available. I really liked the campus when we were here. There seemed to be a focus on students.
Well, one of the other reasons that Penn State Berks was so attractive was because it was in southeastern Pennsylvania with, you know, the number of higher education institutions in the area. And I was looking at this as an opportunity where I would be able to grow professionally. I had been in my position at that point in time for about 5 years or more. It was a little bit insane because he was, you know, just starting out on the tenure track, and so it was pretty incredible in terms of.
I should point out how supportive the college was. I mean, the registrar able to get my teaching schedule so that I could be with the children in the morning and be home by the time they got home from the bus. So I took a lot of work home, but I was still able to feel like I was putting in the time necessary to do my job effectively. And, you know, especially Dave Bender, he was great to work with. The fact that I've been able to witness the growth over the last decade has been incredibly rewarding, and to have played a part in it through the science program. I mean, we're now graduating, you know, 20 to 25 science students a year, whereas all those students used to have to come here and go to University Park. We seem to be serving a vital community need. I'm really proud of the faculty we have in the science program. I mean, we're turning out students who are going to medical school, to chiropractic school, to pharmacy school. We have clinical trial coordinators at major Fortune 500 companies. It's just, and those students are still keeping in touch with us. So the students have felt connected to Berks, and I think that helps us feel even more connected.
The sense of community here among the students, the faculty and staff is wonderful, and it's going to be hard to leave, but I think that that's part of it, and the opportunity. I mean, it's with a background in higher education and a degree in higher education, to be part of an institution that is fairly new and growing is an exciting opportunity in terms of being able to help the college and the faculty and staff define where it wants to go and what its future looks like has been very rewarding. One of the things that I've always respected is that Susan Dr. Spies is very interested in having an inclusive process so that individuals have the opportunity to voice an opinion and have feedback into the process.
Within the first year or two, Mary Ellen Weimer was in the associate dean role at that point and approached me about being the coordinator. I was hesitant because I was still on the tenure track, but in hindsight, it was one of the best decisions I've made because I've been able to help deal with the administrative hurdles so that the science program could get started quickly. I found out I have more administrative skills than I knew, and I also like working with advising, because when I got here I was advising in business, and you know, I could help them choose classes, but I couldn't really do a lot with advising. Now I advise students who are graduating here. I see them all 4 years. I help them get into various programs. The life science program has expanded in large part because the pharmaceutical industry in southeast Pennsylvania is booming. Wyeth and Merck and GlaxoSmithKline. My research is on fetal alcohol syndrome, so even though I have done a lot of research on teaching and pedagogy, I continue to have a lab. I have involved anywhere from 1 to 3 students almost every semester that I've been here. We use a chicken model, and it's the embryo, so students can quickly make some injections, get some data, start analyzing it. I've now published with 4 or 5 undergraduates. They have peer-reviewed scientific publications. It's been great. The students have had the opportunity to travel to national meetings.
I look at the opportunity to work with students in our office because I think that it's from a student development perspective, that theory to practice to theory helps, just as Ike said, students gain an understanding of what research is, how you ask a question, how you understand that particular question, and the tools that you have available to explore questions. And by having the practical experience in the institutional research or the planning research and assessment office gives them an opportunity to explore.
But when students look back on their college career, they remember the activities that they did. So they're going to remember internships and undergraduate research opportunities, trips that they took, far more than they're going to remember the classes that they took. So it really is, as far as an enriching educational experience, I don't think it can be beat.
Very rewarding, you still have those aha moments even though it's a student worker, an internship type experience.
But I think the opportunity to work on a problem and follow it through for 3 semesters, 4 semesters, 5 semesters, and ask the questions, get the hands-on experience, and then have to present it, these meetings ties in with what we're trying to do for our students as far as giving them opportunities to develop communication skills and leadership ability and critical thinking. So undergraduate research ties in with that, ideally.
The qualities that students bring into an office, I mean, you set certain parameters, but they really help you stay connected, especially where our office is located. We're located in the Onsen Conference Center. There's no one else there but us, other than the occasional meeting or retreat. So, you know, it helps us feel like we're staying connected to essentially the lifeblood of the college in terms of the students. So it's very rewarding.
I think if we have degree programs that involve a lot of these enriching experiences, that to me is what's setting Berks apart from a lot of other institutions. And we're really doing a great job, and I hope we can build on the success we have without losing a lot of what has brought us to this point.